J.D. Calaruso joins us right now, the UAlbany goalie. Does it shock you to know that when we talked to Coach Scott Maher, he basically said you were crazy?
Does not shock me at all. I mean, goalie is the craziest position in lacrosse, I'd say that, and probably maybe in all sports. We wear no padding. We wear a chest protector, a cup, gloves, and a helmet, and that's it. You know, my shins always get them bruised up, my arms. So basically my whole body is always bruised up. But
I played goalie in high school, like for like freshman year or whatever, and stuff like that. And, you know, they're not coming at me 90 miles per hour in high school, and that hurt. So do you ever, he said, I'm just trying to get you to wear pads in practice. Do you ever just think about maybe just in practice throwing some pads on?
I've been, in the last couple of weeks, I've been thinking about that because, like, every day I'm just getting hit with shots. So I'll probably take that into consideration soon. Maybe next week start putting some pads on.
Especially you have a good offense. You know what I mean? Your team is legit, so you probably face – do you face a better offense? I'm sorry, guys. I like lacrosse, so leave me alone.
No, I just heard something behind you. But we're getting attacked by me. You're good.
Do you face a better offense in practice or in most of these games?
I'd say in practice. You know, like, our team is up-tempo. And, of course, we have one of the best attackers in the country in Connor Fields. And he can rip the ball really fast. And our middies can all shoot really fast. And I think our offense puts up, like, 17 goals a game. So.
Woo.
I think we scored 17 last weekend. We scored 17 against UMass. So we've been putting up lots of goals per game. So I think just that shows how good our offense is and how they're probably ranked one of the best in the country, too.
You redshirted last season. You learned from the big fellow, Blaze Reardon, that SportsCenter caliber play where he's running down. What was it like? Blaze is a teammate, and take us to that moment when he had that goal a few seasons ago.
Yeah, I mean, Blaze is a great teammate. You know, like, when I came in, he was a starter, and I tried my best to try and get some playing time, but he was just that good. But I just learned a lot from him. You know, as a player, like, on and off the field, how hard he worked to get as good as he is. And that goal was just crazy, and you know? No one expected that. He never really runs off the field. But, like, like a lot of people know, he plays box lacrosse, which is indoors, and he has great stick skills, which probably people didn't know about that at all. But when he was running off the field, I was just like, I didn't even expect. I thought he was going to pass the ball, but that day I remember it was really hot out, and Cornell, they only ran like one midi line, I'd say, and they were really tired. And Blaze gets tired easily, but he just had one run he had to do. So once he split that. He just threw a fake, and he ripped it, and he started running back towards the goal. You know, it was just a crazy experience.
J.D. Calaruso with us, UAlbany's goalie for the lacrosse team. Now, you're more athletic than Blaze. Let's get on SportsCenter.
This weekend, maybe, against Maryland, take off?
So, you know, in practice, I'm always running off the field sometimes. I haven't really had a good chance to run off the field yet, but hopefully in the future I'll be running off the field sooner or later.
Well, that's like, whenever we talk to the players, Scott Maher lets us be ourselves. Is that, like, am I going to get you in trouble for trying to talk you to run up the field? Or is that something he's like, hey, if you've got it, take it, but no, you have it kind of thing?
No, exactly. Coach Maher gives us a lot of freedom on the field, you know. I think he knows our abilities. He knows what abilities we have on the field. And I think he's one of the coaches. He's not really a big screamer at us and all that. He's a very calm guy because I didn't really like a coach who would just scream at you. You know, he just kind of just put you down. You know, he keeps it positive. Especially when you're playing on the field, like during games, he doesn't freak out or anything. You know, he's very calm, and like all the coaches have a positive, you know, a positive impact towards the game. So, I think hopefully one day I'll run off the field though soon.
Well, let's go back to your recruiting process because that's an interesting thing that maybe potential recruits are hearing this style of Coach Maher. What schools were you looking at, and was that the ultimate reason why you decided to come to UAlbany?
See, so when I was a little kid, you know, my dad knew Coach Maher, so I would come up and watch all the Albany games when I was a little kid. So, like, I've kind of always wanted to come here. And I remember my sophomore year summer, I was at a recruiting showcase. It's called Maverick Showtime, and I played really well. I made the All-Star game there, and there was a bunch of college coaches there. And I had a pretty good game in the All-Star game. And so, like, he started recruiting me after that. And so I went and visited, and that's literally the only school I visited was Albany.
Wow.
I mean, a couple other schools have contacted me. I think it was like Binghamton, like Marist, Delaware, Fairfield. But, you know, once I visited Albany, I knew it was the place I wanted to go to. And just because coach, like when I came here for my visit, all the coaches were really laid back, you know, and they play a very high tempo offense. And I think when I make saves, I try to get the ball up really quick. I think that really helps.
J.D. Calarusso, the UAlbany goalie with us right now, 104.5 The Team.
Has the locker room this week leading into the matchup changed at all? I know you guys know how big the game can be. With all the focus on the program, is it a little added pressure? Has the intensity picked up in your guys' practices?
I would say every day in practice, you know, we try and work harder and harder to get better. I think this week we're just really focused, you know, like the opportunity we have in front of us is unlike no other. This only happens once in a lifetime, basically. And I think tomorrow we're going to – it's like a pregame practice, so tomorrow we're going to come out and work hard as well. And we just have to get as ready as we can be for Saturday.
J.D., you know, you're going to play goalie in this big game against Maryland, but the weekend itself here at UAlbany is big. 4:30 tomorrow, the girls' basketball team, they're taking on Maine. They can win an America East title. We have decided – we were going to do a block party just for you guys, 12 to 3. We're going to hang out, just get everybody ready. But with UAlbany playing hoops, we said, you know what, we're taking over the SEFQ. We're going to have a viewing party, 11 o'clock, we start that, and then we're coming over to you guys. You know, we're throwing on the winter coats, yeah, and we're cheering on you guys. Do you realize that, like, it's going to be really cold and that Scott Maher called for this? Like, Scott Maher has been telling me for 2 weeks, I hope it's cold when Maryland comes here. Like, do you want to just, like, secretly, like, we can, like, I know he's not listening. Do you want to say anything negative about Coach for wishing this on? Because they're hurling 90-mile-per-hour rocks at you, and it's cold.
I know. It's
and you love it. Look at you, crazy little. Get a little smile.
Yeah. It's going to be crazy. I mean, I don't think Maryland plays in that cold of weather. I mean, we're really used to it. So
right.
It could help us a little bit. But, yeah, I mean, this weekend is just going to be great for the university, you know. Just hopefully be a lot of people out supporting the games. I know people are going home for spring break, but hopefully the Albany community can come out. But back to the cold weather, I heard it's going to be like 20 with lots of wind, too. So it's going to be a wild ass. I don't even know what to say about
that. And we can bundle up. You're going to be out there with
I'll probably wear a sweatshirt. I wore a sweatshirt last game in Cornell. It was like 25, and I wore a sweatshirt. Some leggings under my sweatpants that I wear, so
closest thing to pads you've worn.
Yeah, exactly.
So Gaz is now mad at me because I saw your sophomores. They all have mohawks. I said, you guys beat Maryland. I will let you give Gaz and I mohawks.
Okay, hell yeah. Definitely.
I don't know what he's more excited about. The cold and the 90-mile-per-hour fastballs coming at him or the Mohawks.
Yeah, he lit up about the Mohawks. Are they doing that by choice? Is that a tradition?
Yeah, I think they just do that.
What?
I mean, I'd say last year before, so for the American East Championship, and unfortunately we didn't make it, but for the playoffs, we all dyed our hair blonde. Not all of us, but a bunch of us did. And some had mohawk, blonde mohawks as well. But this year, I don't know why they're doing that, just for some fun, I think.
Well, if you guys do what we know you can do and take down Maryland, we're going to have mohawks. We're doing it right after
awesome.
The game.
We don't have to do it after the game. You guys can pick when you want. Right. They can celebrate. We do not have to bust into their locker room. They can do what they want.
We'll make sure to bring something in our locker room.
Oh, my goodness. No.
See? I like it. J.D. Calarusso, hoping for you to have a fantastic game Saturday. We'll be here. Again, we're taking over the SEFQ before. We're going to watch UAlbany hopefully take down the America East for hoops, and then you guys beat the highest-ranked team, brave enough or dumb enough to come to Albany to play you guys. J.D., I hope you have a great game, man.
Thank you. I appreciate it. Thanks for having me.